Okay, to conclude, in 2003, and for the first time in the history of the award, the National Artist Award was given in the field of theater and design. And fittingly, it was presented to Salvador Espronal, not because he pioneered theater design in the country, but because he was the first to develop it as a profession. He was the first to elevate it to the level of an art form. He created more than 250 theater productions marked by artistic integrity and excellence. He trained a significant number of designers and artisans who have continued to renounce artistic legacy. He established the first professional organization of theater designers and technicians in the country. He proved to all and sundry that the poverty of a budget need not imply a poverty of imagination. And lastly, he contributed to the formation of nations by being the best artist that he could be. Round of applause.
Designers were expected to be decorated. Right?
So kung ano lang yung sabihin ng director, hindi recommend siya of a rich man, pwede, you know, lalagay ko ng mga dekorasyon para mabasa ng mansion mayaman. What Padong did was, he interpreted the material the way the director interpreted it. Because he was the director himself. Right? So in other words, he added meaning to the production. Hindi lang siya yung inuutusan ng director. As a matter of fact, Padong was such a strong personality that he actually raised the level, right, of the production, the artistic level of the production, to a point where the collaborating artists had to work themselves up to that level. Sinasabi ni Sheila Villero, Ballet Philippines productions would not have been that, you know, have that international feel if Padong had designed them. In fact, what happened was Padong's designs were so good, they felt they had to dance, you know, well in them. And anyway, he had that kind of effect on the audience. He was always looking for something new for every tulang. Doon sa circa, may ginawa siya doon, actually, alatang sa picture. Pero, in-interpret niya, kasi in-interpret niya yung 1907 kasi is when the international assembly opened. And the Americans, yung American culture, the Filipino culture, plus economic interest, political interest, and so on. So parang, the Philippines was yung ibon na tulong sa hapas. Eh, ginamit ko for that scene, yung original song, original part of the Philippines, which is ang bayan. So, ginawa niya ang metaphor doon, yung pag kinakata yung maya, Noemi comes from the top of the stairs, yung two stairs na magkana, imperial staircase, nilagay niya sa kitaan, sa taas, na parang kotse, parang balcony, pero mukha siyang cage. So doon muna dudumaw si Noemi when she starts to sing ang Maya. So yung status niya, from the very start, yung image of a bird which is in cage, which is a metaphor for the action. Mga ganun, no? He adds meaning. Hindi siya ano lang, talagang meron siyang nadadagdag. Yumayaman yung production, hindi lamang visually, kundi intellectually, inside siya. May inside siya sa mga design. You realize nga ako pala, hindi yung poor production, ano? Yun ang pinaka-generous na budget na nakuha niya. Kaya makikita niya yung costumes sa real silk and sa real details. And we have, what, three sets of costumes. One of since sila division. Just to start off with your question, Mr. Reyes. It was dominated by the Philippine group. Actually, Nestor Hardin proposed that as a big project of ASEAN. Dapat may involve lahat ng ASEAN members and this. So, ang design was actually supposed to be Malaysia. But we realized that na sa production pala, sa end of the production, the Philippines is the most advanced. So we ended up dominating. So I wrote the project on the choreography, but it was supposed to be a guide to do the choreography. It didn't work out. Sila ba nilin minsan. Minsan was just overall at the city. And then, si the Malaysian did not work out. Saka yung VMR in terms of such a portion, we had to call the Patong. Late si Patong, minsan, it was in Rama. Hindi siya talaga dapat kung kasi according to the rules, each country must participate, di ba? Eh, wala. Hindi nila talaga kaya. Even in terms of yung professional production design, wala silang support. So we ended up with the Philippine team and the running the show.
I think there are a couple of designers practicing that kind of design. But we're also up against very unprofessional designers who not just rip off, but because Bilbao has elevated the designer who into a real profession. Whereas there's some designers who actually don't do their task in such a way that you don't do research. That's one major problem. And it's rather than design, which really brings it down to actually get a hobby. But Patong has been so many people, not just here, but abroad. So there are many people who are practicing this medical design in New York and Switzerland. I think they're more sensitive young designers now. I've seen a couple of people here from both Ateneo and Dula. In fact, a lot of them are even more interesting than the professional civil service. And that's the task, I think.
Chris Miliado, Vice President and Artistic Director of the CCT. It's actually one of the main proponents of this project started in 2011.
Maganda na po sa inyong lahat. Siguro dalawang aspect doon sa tanong na yun, ano, kung paano pinapakatuloy ngayon yung legacy ni Batong Bernal, self-designer, yung kanyang kasilingan. Yung unang-una siguro, makikita doon kung ano yung status ng self-design sa CCT, yung isang pinag-final. Yung una, yung tagayang talagang ay production design center. So originally, ang vision ito ay isang training center para sa set design, costume design, and technical theater. Isa ito sa isang malungkot na nangyari dahil sa kanya nang